Tim has already changed. He's already changed. And you wonder about this because the Radio Caribbean is owned by a Labour Party stalwart. And you wonder what's going on.
And it's in that regard that Mr. Wayne says it is interesting now that the media is under pressure that anyone thinks that they can, in his words, scare the pants off them.
I was thinking it might be a nice retaliatory move if all the media houses decided they were not going to cover political activities. And by political, I mean government as well. And then I thought, well, what would be the point? Because the government has its own cameramen and whatnot. I'm not too hot on this, so I don't know if they can. They have NTN. I don't know if NTN can function without other involvement. I don't know. But they certainly have Radio St. Lucia and whatever. So I don't think it would prove any point. But having said that, and having also said that I think the media has rendered itself so soft and so without muscle.
According to Rick Wayne, it would be a nice retaliatory move by what he called the gutless media not to cover political or government activities.
The only retaliatory move would be that journalists do their job even better. You know, that might be a nice retaliatory move. When you're interviewing a politician, stop playing games. Ask about his background. Like during the campaign, there were at least four politicians who could have done with some serious background checking. And nobody cared enough to do about that. So the media has contributed a lot to this mess that we're in today. And it's ironic that some of that mess is falling on our faces.
Rick Wayne, owner of the Star newspaper, made no bones about the state of the media to date, while being very critical of the St. Lucia media. He says that as a result of the current situation, and if things continue as they are, politicians may well take advantage and have their way with the St. Lucia media.
This sacrificing of Timothy Poleon that's going on right now is a sacrificing of the people, you know. Just imagine that if all the media closed down and the only voice you heard was the voice of the government, because bet your life, if the media closed down, you will not hear the voice of the opposition in our circumstances, whoever the opposition might be, okay? So you're only going to hear the voice of the government. Imagine that state of affairs, but it's close. And again, I am blaming, to a large extent, not despotic governments, but pathetic media. I keep on saying, quoting Sir Vincent Flossack, who made the point at a particular media awards ceremony, that the law is very much on the side of journalists. They just don't know it.
Rick Wayne says he had his fair share of lawsuits and believes such suits are an attempt to muzzle the media. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingseed reporting.